स्टूडेंट
सॉल्युबिलिटी, व्हाट इज सॉल्युबिलिटी? सॉल्युबिलिटी डेफिनेशन मींस द मैक्सिमम अमाउंट ऑफ the maximum amount of solute in the maximum amount of solute in 100 grams of solvent 100 grams of solvent is known as solubility, is denoted by S. So according to this definition, the S is equals to the weight of solute divided by weight of solvent into 100 is known as solubility. So based on this solubility definition is what, dear students? The maximum amount of solute dissolved in are present in 100 grams of solvent is known as solubility. So based on the solubility concept, substances, they are divided into three types. So the next point, let's see, dear students, based on solubility, substances divided into three types. So based on the solubility, substances, they are divided into how many types, dear students? Three types. What are those? The first one is soluble substances. What is the meaning of soluble substances? Soluble substances means in which, means this kind of substances are this kind of solutions in which solute quantity is more. In which the solute, the weight of solute is more than 1 gram. The weight of solute is more than 1 gram. Means solute quantity is more than 1 gram present in a solvent. Such kind of substances are called as soluble substances. Okay, these soluble substances, solubility, this kind of substances, solubility is greater than or equals to 0.1 molar. The solubility is more than 0.1 molar or equal to 1 molar. So the soluble substances, solubility, yes. Okay, examples, if you have heard that, potassium chloride, sodium chloride, barium chloride, this kind of salts are more soluble in solvents. So the soluble substances means you have to just remember that this numerical values is enough, examples not required. So that soluble substances definition means in which the solute quantity is more than 1 gram, those are called as soluble substances. The second one is sparingly soluble substances means in which solute weight is less than 1 gram and more than 0.1, less than 1 gram and more than 0.001 grams. Like the solute quantity is in between 1 gram, less than 1 gram and more than 0.001 grams present, such kind of solutions or such kind of substances are called as sparingly soluble substances. These sparingly soluble substances, their solubility is less than 0.1 molar and more Molarity, you have to remember, the sparingly soluble substances solubility is less than 0.1 molar and more than 0.01 molar. Examples. Examples, silver chloride, silver iodide, lead sulfate, barium sulfate, these are the examples for sparingly soluble substances. Okay students, the third one is insoluble substances. Just definitions are common. If the solute quantity is more than 1 gram, soluble. Less than 1 gram and more than 0.001 gram, then it is sparingly soluble. If the solute quantity is very, very less, then such kind of substances are called as insoluble substances. The third one is insoluble substances. These insoluble substances, the solute quantity, solute weight is less than, solute weight is less than 0.001 grams. Means the solute quantity is very, very less. Such kind of substances are called as insoluble substances. Their solubility is very, very less. The solubility is less than 0.01 molar. The solubility is less than 0.01 molar. Such kind of substances are called as insoluble substances. Now, the soluble substances forms three types of solutions. Okay, ma'am? Let's see the next concept. The soluble substances forms are making mainly three types of solutions. What are the three types of solutions, dear students? Already we know that saturated solutions, unsaturated solutions, and super saturated solutions. Okay, let's begin. The next concept is soluble substances forms three types of solutions. Soluble substances forms three types of solutions. What are the three types of solutions, dear students? The first one is unsaturated solutions. Unsaturated solution. What is the meaning of unsaturation? Already we know that in lower classes only, first year only, we are studied about that saturated, unsaturated, super saturated solutions. I think in equilibrium chapter we are discussing. So unsaturated solutions means in which the solute quantity is less than the making of saturated solutions. Okay, unsaturated solutions in which solute quantity, solute weight is less than required for the saturation. Solute quantity is less than required for the saturation. Such type of solutions are called as unsaturated solutions. Means unsaturated solutions okay students unsaturated solution means in which solute quantity is less when compared for the required for the making of saturated solution. Okay, such type of solutions are called as unsaturated solution. Means unsaturated solution still required more quantity of solute for making of saturated solution. Now the second one is saturated solutions means in which the solute quantity is how much quantity of solute is required, the same quantity of solute is present. Means the solute quantity, solute means in which required amount of solute, required amount of solute present. If the solution contains how much amount of solute is required, the same amount of solute if it is present means forms saturated solution. So in saturated solutions exist equilibrium state in which equilibrium state exists. So if equilibrium state is existing means the rate of dissolution is equal to rate of crystallization. So in which rate of dissolution is equal to rate of crystallization. Okay, because of equilibrium state is existing. That's why in saturated solutions means how much quantity of solute is required, the same quantity of solute is present. That's why in saturated solutions the rate of dissolution is equal to rate of crystallization. Okay students, now the third one is unsaturated is over and super saturated solutions. So super saturated solution means more quantity of solute is present than required for the saturation, in which more amount of solute, more amount of solute present than for saturated solution or than for saturation. So the more amount of solution is present means in super saturated solutions precipitation will forms. This is also nothing but precipitated solutions in which metastable state exists, in which metastable state is nothing but precipitation students. So in which metastable state is formed. Okay, so the super saturated solution is nothing but the solutions in which more amount of solute is present than required for the saturation solution. So such kind of solutions are called as super saturated solutions. So in super saturated solutions more amount of solute is present means precipitation will form. That precipitation formation is nothing but metastable state. So these are the types of solutions. Okay students, so the soluble substances forms three types of solutions. One is unsaturated solution, the second one is saturated solutions, the third one is super saturated solutions. So in saturated solutions equilibrium state is existing, then the rate of dissolution process is equal to rate of crystallization process, or amount of dissolution means the amount of solute is dissolved in the solution is equal to amount of undissolved solute in the solution. Both are equal. Then that state is called as equilibrium state. That equilibrium state is existing in a saturated solution. This is about the types of solutions. Types of solutions. Now we need to discuss about that important factors. Factors affecting the solubility of solids in liquids. And at the same time, we need to discuss about that factors affecting the solubility of gas in liquids. So these two we need to discuss, and these two factors also very very important, compulsory either in board examination as well as in objective exam also they are asking questions. Okay students, let's see. Listen carefully. The next one is factors affecting the solubility factors affecting the solubility of solids. Factors affecting the solubility of solids in liquids. Okay, means solubility of solids. For example, NaCl, sodium chloride is present. The sodium chloride you have to dissolve in water. That is called a solid in liquid solution. So, is nothing but the solubility of solid and liquid solutions factors we need to discuss. What are the important factors affecting the solubility of solid in liquids? Solubility of a solid in a liquids we need to discuss. These factors are important now. Let's see the first factor, temperature. How the temperature is affecting on the solubility of solids in liquids. So the temperature means actually the dissolution process means the solute is dissolved in a solvent and it is converted into solution. That process is known as dissolution process. So the dissolution process is two types. One is endothermic process. The second one is exothermic process. So the temperature effect is depends on the rate of dissolution. If the rate of dissolution is endothermic process, then the temperature increases and the solubility of solids in a liquids increases. So two conditions are present here students. The first one is if the rate of dissolution process is exothermic. Exothermic means it releasing energy. The delta H is equal to negative. The rate of dissolution process is exothermic, then temperature increases, the solubility of solids in liquids decreases. Okay students, the first point is the rate of dissolution process is exothermic. Exothermic means it releases energy, it releases temperature, amount of heat releases. That's why delta H is negative sign. Already in first year thermodynamics there we discussed what is exothermic process and endothermic process and all. So if the rate of dissolution process is exothermic, then the temperature increases and the solubility of solids in liquids decreases. Means the solubility is decreasing. Reverse, if temperature we have to decrease, means low temperature, means The temperature is low, the solubility of solids in liquids increases. Means the low temperatures are favorable for the increasing the solubility. If the rate of degeneration process is exothermic, the rate of degeneration process is exothermic. For this case, examples for making of NaOH solution, sodium hydroxide solution, and cuprous sulfate and sodium sulfate, Na2SO4. These all are the examples for the rate of dissolution is exothermic process. For this case, the temperature increases, then the solubility of solids in liquids decreases. Now the second condition, if the rate of dissolution rate of dissolution process is endothermic, the rate of dissolution process is endothermic. Okay students, if the rate of dissolution process is endothermic, endothermic means the delta H is equals to positive. Under this condition, how the temperature is affecting on the solubility of solids in liquids? Under this condition, then the temperature increases, solubility of solids in liquids increases. The solubility of solids in liquids increases. When the temperature increases, the solubility will be increases. When the rate of dissolution process is endothermic. When the rate of dissolution process is endothermic. Okay students, for this case examples, NaCl, sodium chloride is dissolving in water, then it is the rate of dissolution process is endothermic process only. Then the temperature increases, the solubility of NaCl in water will be increases. The solubility of NaCl will be increases. And sodium nitrate, potassium nitrate, like these salts are dissolving in water, its solubility is increases with increasing temperature. First factor is temperature effect. So how we are explained the temperature effect, dear students? The temperature effect were explained by using delta H sign. If the resolution process or for the making of the solution, if the solution for making of solution, the solution is releasing energy, means it is the exothermic process, then the temperature increases, the solubility will be decreases. If reverse, the dissolution process is endothermic process, then the temperature increases, then the solubility of solids in liquids increases. Now the second factor, pressure. Effect of pressure. Okay students, so the pressure effect is negligible when the solubility of solids in liquids, because the solids and liquids compressibility is high. Okay, that's why pressure does not affect on the solubility of solids in liquids. So pressure effect, it does not affect, it's negligible. Negligible or does not affect. Does not affect. Why? The pressure does not affect on the solubility of solids in liquids, because the solids and liquids has compressibility is high. Sorry, low compressibility. Compressibility is very, very low. Even you have to apply more pressure also, solids and liquids cannot be compressed. Cannot be compressed. That's why the pressure effect does not, pressure does not affect on the solubility of solids and liquids. That's why pressure is negligible. Means you have to increase pressure or decrease pressure, it does not affect on the solubility of solids in liquids. So the pressure effect is only present in solubility of gas in liquids only. The pressure effect is present in a solubility of gas in liquids only, because the gases has compressibility is high. but solids and liquids compressibility is very very low. That's why the pressure does not shows any effect on the solubility of solids in a liquids. Solubility of solids in a liquids. Okay, students. Next factor is nature of solute and solvent. Nature of solute and solvent. Third one. Let's see. Nature of solute and solvent. Okay, if solute is in polar nature as well as solvent is also polar, then the solubility will be first one. If solute is polar nature, okay, solute nature is polar nature. Polar nature means they have a more dielectric constant. And solvent is also polar. Solvent is also polar. Polar solvents means like water and alcohols. Water and alcohols. Then the solubility. Increases. Okay. If the solute is non-polar and the solvent is non-polar. The solvent is non-polar, then the dielectric constant values are low. Then their solubility will be, both are non-polar only. Both are non-polar means like dissolves like. Means polar compounds are soluble in polar solvents only. Non-polar compounds are soluble in non-polar solvents only. Like organic compounds, if you observe that organic compounds all are non-polar solvent. That's why they are soluble in non-polar compound. They are soluble in non-polar solvents like benzene, carbon tetrachloride, hexane, like that. Okay, students. In that case, solubility of solids in liquids increases. Solubility of solids in liquids increases when the solute is non-polar as well as solvent is also in non-polar nature. Then the solubility of solids in liquids increases. Okay, if the reverse is there, reverse means solute is polar and solvent is non-polar, or solute is non-polar and solvent is in polar nature. Under these conditions, the solubility will be decreases. Solubility will be decreases. This is important factor, students. It is nature of a solute and a solvent effect. So the solute and solvents both are in polar nature, solubility will be increases. Both are non-polar nature, solubility will be increases. If one is polar and the other one is non-polar, then the solubility will be decreases. Solubility will be decreases. These are the main important factors affecting on the solubility of solids in liquids. Solubility of solid in a liquids. So one is temperature, the second one is pressure, the third one is nature of solute and solvent. Nature of solute and solvent. Okay, students, let's see the next important concept, factors affecting the solubility of gas in liquids. Okay, factors affecting the solubility of gas in liquids. Gas means the solute is gaseous state and the solvent is in liquid state, means the solubility of gases in liquids, the factors affecting the solubility of gas in liquids we need to discuss. Let's see, the first important factor is temperature effect. Temperature. how the temperature is affecting on the solubility of gas and liquids. So first you have to think about this means the solubility. Of gas in liquids, the solubility of gas in liquids, the dissolution process is always exothermic. Always exothermic. In delta H is equals to negative. Always exothermic. So the dissolution process, the solubility of gas in liquids, the dissolution process is always exothermic. Means the temperature is inversely proportional to solubility of gas in liquids. Therefore, the temperature increases. Solubility of gas in liquids decreases. So the temperature is inversely proportional to dissolution. So solubility of gas in liquids is inversely proportional to temperature. Is always inversely proportional to temperature, ma'am. Because why always inversely proportional to dear students? The dissolution process means the formation of solution, gas in liquids, solubility. The dissolution process is always exothermic. That's why the temperature is inversely proportional to solubility of gas in a liquid. If temperature are increased, then the gas's solubility will be decreased in a given liquids. Okay. For example, we are using soft drinks and all. Once you rub that, always they are keeping that soft drinks in a lower temperatures only, or in refrigerators they are keeping. Why? Means in the refrigerators temperature is very very low. Otherwise, just you are keeping outside and open the cap. Means what happens? It's that solubility means inside that soft drinks carbon dioxide is dissolved. If the temperature is increases in the outside, then the carbon dioxide will comes outside. Means the solubility of gas in liquids will be decreases. The solubility of gas in liquids will be decreases with increasing temperature. The second one is the nature of gas. Nature of a gas. Okay, the nature of gas means actually the solubility of gas in liquids depends on their critical temperature. The gases which are having more critical temperature, they can be easily liquefied, hence their solubility will be more. So the gas